Oh, hi. Today we're going to investigate whether smaller things, like my doggy, can lift heavier things, like the elephant.
Or here's another question. Just a sec. Could our dog Daisy lift me? What do you think?
What do you think, Daisy?
Hey, hi everyone. It's Martin from the Ontario Science Centre. I'm at home, and we wanted to show you some experiments with levers. We asked the question, how can something small lift something big? Or how can something light lift something heavy? One answer to that question would be to make a lever. A lever is basically something long and straight and the point around which it can rotate. So kind of like a seesaw. That's a typical lever. In science, we call this point around which it turns a fulcrum. All right, so let's see the simplest lever that we can build here. Now you put down something round, like a pencil, could be a chopstick, anything slightly round that stays stable on the table. And then you put something long, like the spatula, on it, like that. Place the heavier thing, in my case, the elephant on one side, and the lighter thing, in my case, the little puppy dog, on the other side. So what do you think? And what could we do for the elephant to go up and the doggy to go down? Some people just put their finger on and say, look, the doggy goes down and the elephant's going up. Yes, that's one way. Very good. But what about not using any additional things? Just the lever, the elephant, and the dog. So what could we do to change this? Just experiment. Did you know that the word experiment is a code word? What it really means is to play. So just go about and play. Okay, why don't you try that at home? Press the pause button and try your own setup. How can the puppy lift the elephant? When we come back, I'll show you what one solution is. After playing some time, you might have noticed that if you put the puppy further out, the puppy goes down and the elephant goes up. And if you put the puppy further forward, the elephant goes down, the puppy stays up. There you go. There's something weird. You can make the puppy go forward and then suddenly it switches. It tips. With this simple lever, there's a tipping point. Either the elephant is down or the puppy is down. We have to come up with a different lever system for it to get balanced. Let me show you how. For this setup, I found a cardboard box in the recycling and I covered it up with some paper. What we're going to do is we're going to just find approximately the middle and put one of these pins into it. And now just take the pin and touch it somewhere. The other side, see, you can see that side goes down. And if I put it here, that side goes down. So what I'm trying to do is find the point where it's more or less balanced. There we go. And so now we need something to support that. I just take two glasses and put them onto my table here. And now we got the point where the two are balanced. So I'm going to place that off in here and find the point where the system is balanced with the doggy. And if you put the doggy further back, that side goes down. Kind of as a way to weigh things. What else could you use this for? Here's an additional question. If you have no puppy, just the elephant, where does the elephant need to stand so it's still balanced? Why don't you pause the video and try this at home with your own setup? By the way, if you're wondering how to figure things out, have a look at my t-shirt. You see this slogan, ask, test, repeat? That's the core of how we do science. You have a question, don't know the answer, you come up with a possible answer, and then you test it. And you watch what happens, you observe, you check everything out, and maybe you find the answer. If you don't have the answer, like, okay, what else could I ask about it? What else could I try? Test it out, see what happens. And it goes in this circular process, where you ask a question, you play around with the possibilities, and if it doesn't work out, you try something else. Just keep on testing, keep on trying. In this process, the great thing is that you can't really make any mistakes. Every time it doesn't work, it gives you more information on how to solve a problem or how to answer a question. At the beginning, we asked the question, can our dog Daisy lift me? We then played with levers and we found a way to do it. Here's a lever we built from things in our house. For Daisy to lift me, she has to be much farther from the fulcrum. Let's see how it goes. If I'm here, I can lift my feet. Good girl. Stay, Daisy. Stay. Ah! Okay. What happened? Good girl. High five. Very good. Okay. Here you go. Get some treats. Yeah. Good treats, right? Mm-hmm. Yummy.